Hi, welcome back. I just wanted to do this short video. It is hair related. It is not a wig review. It is a do-it-yourselfer's look on what I do with my wigs. Somebody had asked me about where I store my wigs, and I know a lot of YouTubers, they store them in their boxes and pile their boxes up in their closet. I live in a 120-year-old home with my family, and back then, not every bedroom had a closet, and the main bedroom that me and my husband sleep in, there's only one closet, and we shared that closet. We've been in this house for 20 years, and every season it was a seasonal ritual. We would clear out the one season and put those clothes in a bin and put them up in the attic. And that's what we did every season, like clockwork. We would change out because the closet's only so big. So I had made a shelf in my bedroom, sort of like the shelf behind here you see on this wall here, very, very similar to that. And I had all my wigs stored up one there, and my collection quickly outgrew the size of the shelf. So my husband came up with the idea and said, this is our catch-all small little bedroom, and the odd chair, the odd rocker, the odd table, whatever, it just housed it. So he said, why don't you take that room and make it into your wig room? And I ran with it. I was like, that's a great idea. So what I did was I came across some hollow pocket closet doors by the roadside, and I brought them home, and then I connected them all together. Very simple construction, and I made myself a wig closet. In some of my videos, I have said I just love the fact that I can open up my closet and pull out an outfit, blazer, pants, and pull out a coordinating wig. Well, this is what I mean. I absolutely love this. I've never had this. Wigs are not wigs. I've never had the luxury of opening up my own closet and everything being there. I always had to share a closet. So this is what I just love it. And there's all my girls up top, dust free. They're in there, nice and snug. It holds 7 across. And I have room in the back for 7 more when I add on to my collection. And I have retired 3 of them. So that's why, you know, I still have room in the back. But I love it. I love the fact that I have my own space to go to. They have their own space. They're not getting dust on them. They're out of the way. And my one daughter's cat, I think if I was to leave one down, she might go over and sniff at it, you know, and maybe even, you know, try and, you know, play with it. She's never done it yet because they've always been up and out of the way. So that's what I did. Like I said, it didn't cost me much of anything. Paint and a couple pieces of framing wood. And then from there, I made myself a hutch for all the wig accessories you accumulate from having wigs. Just like you do with bio hair, you have so much accessories. Well, with wigs, we all know you have accumulated a lot of stuff that you need. So I still have to add doors. I still have to frame out the mirror that's going around it. And of course, I still have to paint it. I have a beautiful burgundy red that I'm going to paint this. And yeah, so it hides everything, and everything's going to be in one spot. Things aren't going to be here. Things aren't going to be downstairs in the kitchen, which is where I did a lot of the videos in the beginning. I'm trying to keep the videos in this room. Unfortunately, on a day like today, where there's only 2 windows and it's an overcast day, it's not much light. So that's why I did a couple of them in the kitchen where the bright lights were coming through to give the full effect of the wigs. And I can go outside on the deck to show you out, you know, the outside light against it. But so yeah, I just wanted to show you what I did to house my wigs. The other thing I wanted to bring up was, while I have you here, is on Denise Sheets' videos, came across a video she had done about making a wig, taking an old wig and sewing a headband around it. And I think she used it for exercising purposes. I've also seen a video where somebody has sewn it into a baseball cap, a wig you're going to discard. Well, this is my very first wig by Paula Young. This is Dylan in Golden Lights. And I loved her. I loved her too much. I didn't practice the less is more with her. And I washed her a lot, and I was just too rough with her. So she has seen better days. So rather than discard her at night, what I did was I had took an existing headband that I had. I don't know if this is coming up, and I had to make it bigger. The headband I had was very tight, so I made it bigger. I had sewn two together because I didn't care. I was sleeping in it, but I sewn the headband around the circumference of the wig, and this is what I wear going to bed. I know it's vain, but when I'm laying there next to my husband, and you know, my head feels cold. You know, and I'm thinking, okay, I don't want to wear a scarf. I have a bed scarf, but it never stays on. It's always getting in the way. It goes around my ears, and I just don't like the feel of it. And so I came up with this one, and I've been wearing her going to bed. I also plop her on first thing in the morning, especially on the weekends. I just plop her on, comb her down, because if I don't, she reminds me of Phyllis Diller. I kid you not, it goes out to here like Phyllis Diller's wig. So I comb her down real quick, and then I can go have my coffee, and my head's cold, and the sight of my short hair and sparse hair, you know, it's just, I guess it's vanity's sake. That's all it is. It's for myself, to make myself feel better, and that's what I've been doing. So if you have an old wig and have a headband, you can, it's a very simple stitch. You can even probably hot glue it. I just stitched it all the way around. I kept stretching the headband as I was going around the circumference of the wig. And it worked out fine. So you could do that if you choose to have one to sleep in, or to just, you know, get your cup of coffee in the morning. But anyway, excuse me, I just got home from work and I wanted to do this before other people came home, because my house gets very busy. So anyway, all right, this is a short video. Any questions or comments, please link below. Thank you all the subscribers that just joined. I know I just did a video yesterday on the wig companies, the new Vibrant. I'm still getting votes in. The majority of people out there saying I should keep her, and I'm leaning towards that. I took her out again. I took her to work. I did that. I took her in work and showed her in the light. She's not as dark as the Mason in work. And I've worn her around the house this morning real quick before I put this is my another wig company. This is Fashion Fever, and this is in Strawberry Whip. And so I wore her all again. This seems to be the one I've been wearing the past few days a lot. I've been wearing her a lot. So I'm going to do like a review on her to show you what the back looks like. And the back is, the fibers are really holding up nicely, I have to admit. But I'll do a video just on that, on my findings between this and Main Attraction. I'm going to do Main Attraction Hollywood, and I also have another one called Catwalk by the wig company. So they're going to be I'm going to wear them for a few more weeks, and then I'm going to do a comparison with the three of them to show you what I have found as far as the fiber and how they're holding up. But yeah, so anyway, I just wanted you to welcome you to my room, to my wig room, my wig, I don't want to call it closet, but my wig room, and show you where I do house everything, and how I made this room into some place that I can go to. And if you're fortunate enough that you have a little room like that, this is something you could do. Very simple. But most new houses have a lot of closets, whereas this 120-year-old gal doesn't. So anyway, all right, thanks for tuning in. Have a great night, and God bless, and I'll talk to you next time. Bye.